What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today we have the Surface Go 3. Someone sent me an email saying that they were having some issues with the 4. I couldn't find the 4 model, but I have the 3 model, which is actually model 1824. It has a Type-C port here, and then the power port. That's all we have. I already configured a bootable flash drive. This flash drive is USB and Type-C. I'm actually going to insert it into the Type-C. And we're gonna start our MDT deployment. We're gonna power it on, but before we do that, we're going to actually hold down the volume down key. Continue holding the volume down until you get this. It's gonna boot into the flash drive. I'm going to hit enter. It's going to start loading up the files. All right, this is a good sign. Microsoft Deployment Toolkit wallpaper has loaded up. All right, we're going to run the wizard. Run the deployment wizard. Excellent. I have two task sequences. I'm actually going to use Windows 11. I'm going to click next here. For the computer name, I'm gonna leave it as the default. I'm not gonna join it to the work group. Let's click next here. I'm not moving any data, so let's click next here. I'm not going to restore any user data, so let's click next there. For the time zone, I am going to change it to Eastern Standard Time. Let's click next here. Let's provide a local admin password. Make sure you remember the password. Awesome. Click next. I'm not going to enable BitLocker. Click next here and let's click begin. All right, so I'm gonna let this happen and let's head over to the lab and I'm gonna show you guys what I did with an MDT to get the USB up and running.
Yes, and we're at the lab and I'm gonna show you guys how I got the bootable flash drive set up within my MDT server. So let's get right into that. All right, so the first thing that we need to do is get the Surface Go drivers. Got to get the drivers so you are able to import them into your MDT server. So believe it or not, Microsoft has this website right here, which hopefully, if I remember, I will post a link at the bottom of the description. And from here, if you scroll down a little bit, it gives you a nice little drop down. If you click on the drop down, it gives you all the Surface. Now, for this example, for this video, I did Surface Go, and they actually give you all the links to redirect you to download the drivers. Now, the one that I started with at the beginning of the video was the Go 3. When I click on that link, it takes me here. I'm going to click on download. You have two flavors, one for Windows 10 and the other is for Windows 11. I want to download the Windows 10 and the Windows 11. I clicked on download. I'm going to drop it inside my downloads folder. So click on save. It's going to start downloading the Windows 10 one and eventually the Windows 11 will start and download for you. Once that's done, I went inside my downloads folder and there goes our Windows 11 and Windows 10 Surface Go 3. It could also be for the Go 4, doesn't matter. Within this folder, within the downloads folder, I held the shift key and I right clicked inside the folder and I clicked on open PowerShell windows here and this loads up. Now the command that I'm going to run to extract the drivers from that MSI file would be the following. Pretty self-explanatory. I'm using the MSI exec command with a parameter of /A. The complete path of where the MSI is located. I am doing the Windows 10 version, and then I am applying a target directory, and I'm going to drop it inside the D drive inside a folder called drivers, Surface, and Windows 10. So I'm going to hit enter there. You're going to get the Windows installer. It's going to start preparing to install. It's going to gather required information, and once this is done, it goes away. You're able to go inside that folder, your target folder, and it's going to give you this. Now, the folder that we are going to use to import our drivers within MDT would be the Surface Update. This is where all those drivers are located. Now, I did the same thing for Windows 11, just the MSI name changes, and just give it a target directory, which would be the Windows 11 folder, which that folder I created myself. You could create it whatever you want. I hit enter here. Again, you're going to get the Windows installer. It's going to prepare to install. It's going to gather required information. Eventually, it's going to disappear. And if you go back inside that folder, you're going to see the MSI and that Surface Update folder. If you go inside that Surface Update folder, again, you're going to see all the drivers for Windows 11. Now, once you're done, we're going to launch up our deployment workbench. And within the out-of-box drivers, I created a couple of folders, Surface Gold 3. And inside that folder, I created two folders called Windows 10 and Windows 11. Now, I'm going to do the Windows 10 first. So I'm going to right-click on that folder. I'm going to click on Import Drivers and pick your destination. I'm going to click on Browse. I am going to go to the D drive, Drivers, Surface, and Windows 10, and then select Surface Update. Click OK. Click Next. Nice little summary. Click Next, and it's going to start importing all those drivers into your MDT deployment share. Once it's done, you're going to get this. I did get a couple of warnings. It looks like some of the drivers are not compatible. You're able to continue. So you are able to hit finish here. And there goes all the Windows 10 drivers. Now, behind the scenes, I already did Windows 11. It's the same process. Just make sure right-click, import drivers, and point to the Windows 11 folder. And then you have all your drivers. Another thing that you have to do is create your task sequences. I already created two task sequences. Hopefully you guys know how to do that. And before you even deploy an operating system to your Surface Go, MDT should be working flawless to the point that you are able to create a virtual machine and deploy an operating system using MDT, okay? If you're having any issues, like any errors, I think I did a video with you guys how to fix all those errors, like the BCD edit error, the VB script error. There's a bunch of errors that I did one video and I showed you guys how to fix it. Make sure your MDT is able to deploy successfully before you can do this. Now, once you create your task sequence, we're going to select our deployment share. We're going to right-click on it. We're going to update the deployment share. We're going to click Next. We're going to click Next here, and we're done. And we're going to click Finish. At the beginning of the video, you saw that I had a bootable flash drive. So how did I do that? Now, I went inside Advanced Configuration. I opened up that folder. I went inside Selection Profile. I right-clicked on Selection Profile. And I picked New Selection Profile. You're going to get the wizard. And I gave it a name. Click Next. And from here, we need to enable or check off the following. We're going to check off the operating system, which is Windows 10, because again, this profile is only for Windows 10. The Surface Go 3, the drivers only for Windows 10. And make sure you check off Task Sequence. Very important. Once you do all that, click Next. A nice little summary. Click Next here. And you're done. Click Finish. Now, I did the same thing with Windows 11. The only thing that I do here was basically pick the operating system, which is Windows 11, pick the drivers, and again, make sure you pick the task sequence. Once you're done here, we're going to head over to Media. We're going to right-click on the Media folder. We're going to pick New Media. From here, we need to insert our media path. This is where I'm going to drop everything into. For the selection profile, it is set to everything, but I am going to switch it to Windows 10. Click Next, a nice little summary, click Next, and you're done, click Finish. You're not really done as of yet. We need to do a couple of things here. We're gonna right click on the Media 001, and we're going to pick Update Media Content. It's gonna start updating, but you're going to get this. Now this is a easy one. So what you could do here, right click on Media 001 and select Properties, and uncheck generate x86 boot image. Once you do that and you apply it and you right click on Media 001 and you select update media content, it's gonna go through with no problem. Now I did the same thing with Windows 11. Just make sure you point it to the correct one and you select the selection profile, which deals with Windows 11 stuff like the operating system and the drivers, and update the content. Now, if you go inside one of those folders, you're going to see that it's going to give you the content. It's also going to give you the ISO. If you go inside Windows 11, it's the same concept, same thing. So on my desktop, within my MDT server, I have Rufus. I'm going to double click on that application. It's going to launch the user account control. I hit yes here. I inserted my flash drive, which is the F drive, which is 64 gigs, because that media is pretty large. So make sure you're inserting a big hard drive. We're going to click on select. And from here, navigate to which ISO you want. I went inside the Windows 11 one. I selected the ISO. I'm going to click open here and just click on start. I've used this flash drive many times, so it has a lot of partitions. So this is the reason why I got this. Yes, here. You're going to get a nice little warning that it is going to erase everything on the flash drive. Click OK. And it's going to start processing. And like you saw at the beginning of the video, you saw me use that flash drive into Surface, and I was able to boot and push out the operating system. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.